Hello friends, welcome back. In our previous lecture, we have started our unit 8, which is quadrilaterals. We have discussed some basics of quadrilaterals also. In this lecture, we will start with exercise 8.1, and we will start with question number first of this exercise. So let's see. Question number first says, angles of a quadrilateral are in the ratio 3:5:9:3:5:9:13. Now they are asking find all the angles of this quadrilateral. We have been given the ratios of all the triangles, or all the angles of quadrilateral. Let's say this ABCD. This is a triangle. Ratio of all the angles. This also, this also, this also, and this also is given to us. They want us to find the exact angles. So let's say, we all know what is sum of quadrilateral. I have told you in the previous lecture that sum of all angles of quadrilateral is equal to 360 degree. So if we say, if we take this as 3x, 3x plus 5x plus 9x plus 13x, sum of all this should be equal to 360. Right? We all know. We can write the reason. Sum of all angles of quadrilateral. Okay. I am writing here quad because there is less space. You just write quadrilateral. Full form. Right? So if we add this, it comes out to be 13 plus 5 is 18. 18 plus 3 is 21, 21 plus 9 is 30. 30x is equal to 360 degree. X is equal to 360 upon 30. If we cancel this, it comes out to be 1, 2. So X is equal to 12 degree. Now we know X, so we can easily find all the angles. So first angle comes out to be 3 into 12 is equal to 36 degree. 5 into 12 is equal to 60 degree. 9 into 12 is equal to 108 degree. And 13 into 12, it comes out to be 13, 12, 26, 13. 156. It comes out to be 156 degree. Now if we add this, it is 6 plus 6 12, 12 plus 8 is 20, 26 plus 3 is 9, 9 plus 2 carry from that, it comes out to be 11, 11 plus 5 is 6, 16, 1, 2 plus 3, 360. Sum of all this comes out to be 360. So it was a very easy question, very basic concept you need to know, that sum of all the angles of quadrilateral is 360 degree, right? So this was question number first. Let's move on to question number second now. Question number second says, if the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, then show that it is a rectangle. It says, let's take this as a parallelogram. It is saying A, B, C, D. It says, if diagonals BD and AC are equal, of a parallelogram are equal, show that it is a rectangle. We all know that diagonals of a parallelogram, they bisect each other, but they are not equal. But for a rectangle, they are equal also, right? So we have to take, again in this we will be using the congruency rules of the triangles. So we have to take two triangles. So let's take this triangle ADC, this, and this BCD. So in triangle ADC and triangle BCD, right? So this AD is equal to BC, opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. AD is equal to AD is equal to BC, it is given because it is a parallelogram. DC is equal to CD, it is common. And this BD and AC, it is given equal. It is given equal and we have to prove it is a rectangle. So AC is equal to BD given, right? So how can we prove it as rectangle? If we prove that this all the sides are 90 degree, so it will be a rectangle, right? So by this, it implies that ADC is congruent to BCD by SSS side congruency rule. So if this is equal, then we can say that this angle ADC and this angle BCD, this is also equal. So it implies angle ADC is equal to angle BCD. CPCT. What was CPCT? Corresponding part of congruent triangles. So this is equal. But if we see this ADC plus BCD, angle ACD plus angle, sorry, ADC. ADC plus angle BCD is equal to 180 degree. Why? If you remember, in triangles there was a property, if there are two parallel lines and there is one transversal passing through them, then this angle plus this angle is equal to 180 degree co-interior angles. Co-interior angles. Now we know that this angle is equal to this angle. We have just proved it by CPCT. So it becomes, if we put ADC in place of BCD, it comes out to be angle twice angle AC, ADC is equal to 180 degree and angle ADC is equal to 90 degree, which is equal to BCD. Now this angle and this angle is 90 degree and opposite angles of parallelogram are also equal. That means angle ADC is equal to 90 degree is equal to angle CBA, or we can say ABC. Similarly, angle DAB is equal to 90 degree is equal to angle BCD. By which property? Opposite angles of parallelogram are equal. Now we have already, we know that opposite sides are equal, they are parallel, diagonals bisect each other as well as diagonals are equal to each other, and we have also proved that all angles are 90 degrees. So it implies that ABCD is a rectangle. Right? So easy question. What we had to prove? We had just had to prove that all angles are 90 degree. Everything else is given to us. Okay? We took angle ADC and BCD. We proved it congruent by SSS, side congruency rule. We proved these two angles are equal by CPCT. So by proving that, and all angles are equal to, opposite angles are equal to each other, by that we get that ABC is a rectangle. So this was question number 2 of exercise 8.1. Now let's move on to third question of this exercise. Question number third. Now what does question number third say? Question number third says, show that if the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other at 90 degrees, then it is a rhombus. It says, let's take, this is a quadrilateral, A, B, C, D. It says that if they are bisecting each other at 90 degrees, then it is a rhombus, right? This is, let's take this as point O. So, what are the properties of a rhombus? Properties of a rhombus are all sides are equal and diagonals bisect each other at 90 degrees, but they are not equal. In this, we have been given that diagonals are bisecting each other at 90 degrees. Now, we have to prove that AB is equal to BC is equal to DC is equal to AD, right? So, let's start. Again, we will take two triangles. In this, let's first take this AOB and this COD. In triangle AOB and triangle COD, right? In this, AO is equal to OC. This is equal to this because they are bisecting diagonals given, right? And angle AOB is equal to angle COD is equal to 90 degree. Diagonals are bisecting each other at 90 degree, or we can also say they are vertically opposite angles also. We can also say vertically opposite angles also, whichever you want to write, right? If you want to write 90 degree, you can write 90 degree also. Plus OB is equal to OD. This is also given because diagonals are bisecting each other. So if we see triangle AOB, it is congruent to triangle COD. By which property? Side, angle, side. S-A-S. Right. Now, we can say that this AB, it is equal to DC. Now, it implies that AB is equal to CD. By which property? CPCT, corresponding part of congruent triangles. Right. We have proved these two as equal. Now, we have to prove that all these also are equal. Then only it will be a rhombus. So, this was first part. Now, if we take other two triangles, let's take this triangle. This one, below one. This. Yeah. We will take this. In triangle COD and triangle COB. Right? In this triangle and this triangle, OC is equal to CO, it is common, right? This OD is equal to OB, it is diagonals are bisecting, so they are equal, given. And angle COD is equal to angle COB is equal to 90 degree. It is also given to us because diagonals are bisecting each other at 90 degree. So, if we see, then these two triangles are congruent by which rule? Side, angle, side. So, it implies triangle COD is congruent to triangle COB by side, angle, side. Now, by CPCT, we can say that CD is equal to BC. CD is equal to BC by CPCT. Now, if CD is equal to BC, but CD is also equal to AB, that means AB is equal to BC is equal to CD. Now, we can take any two triangles. Similarly, this triangle and this triangle is also congruent. So, if this side is equal to this side, that means all the sides are equal. So, we can write, similarly, triangle COD is congruent to triangle COD is triangle to AOD. It implies CD is equal to AD, side angle side, by CPCT. If we take this as 1, this is 2, this is 3. So I'm rubbing this upper part, this one. I hope you have written it down. So from 1, 2 and 3, it implies AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to AD. So it implies ABCD is a rhombus. Easy question. That's what we had to prove. That prove that this quadrilateral is a rhombus. So this was question number third. We have to take three triangles. First we took these two, then we took these two. Similarly, these two are also congruent, and by the CPCT which we have proved, we can easily prove that ABCD is a rhombus. So this was third question. Let's move on to fourth question now. Question number fourth. Question number fourth says, show that diagonals of square are equal and bisect each other at 90 degree. So we have to prove that diagonals of a square are equal as well as bisect each other at 90 degree. So let's take this as square. We will be needing a bigger figure for this. If you are noting the questions down, then I recommend you to note it down with me as well. So that if I rub, because this question will be a lengthy question, I will have to rub the blackboard. So ABCD is a square. We have to prove that diagonals are equal and bisect each other at 90 degree, right? Okay. Now we will be starting with in triangle ADC and BCD. In triangle ACD and triangle BCD. Right? So AD is equal to BC. Opposite sides of square are equal, so it is given, right? DC is equal to CD, it is common, right? We know that also. Now we have two things. We also know that these angles are 90 degree, so they are also equal. So angle ADC is equal to angle BCD is equal to 90 degree given. So again, this both triangles are congruent by which rule? It implies triangle ACD and triangle BDC are congruent by side angle side congruency rule. It implies this AC is equal to BD. AC is equal to BD by CP. Right? Now we have proven that one part is proved that diagonals are equal. I have already proved that diagonals are equal. Now I have to prove diagonals are diagonals bisect each other at 90 degree, right? So this is AC is equal to BD. This I have proved first part. I am rubbing this part. If you have not noted it down, just note it down. Okay, this was first part. Now we have to prove that diagonals bisect each other at 90 degree. How we can prove that? Let's take this as angle 1, this is angle 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, this is 7, this is 8. Now if you remember, I have told you one property, if two lines are parallel and there is a transversal cuts through them, there is a Z forming, if you remember, I have told you in triangles. Then this angle 1 is equal to angle 8 and this angle 2 is angle 1 is equal to angle 8, right? Alternate angles, right? These are alternate angles. Similarly, if this is the Z forming, then angle 5 is equal to angle 4. And if this is the Z forming, this one, this is, then angle 2 is equal to angle 7 and this angle 6 will be equal to angle 3. So we can write that angle 1 is equal to angle 8, angle 2 is equal to angle 7, angle 5 is equal to angle 4 and angle 6 is equal to angle 3. They are all interior angles, right? Alternate angles. So this we have proved. Now we have to take two triangles. First of all, which two triangles? Let's take, if we take this and this, yeah, let's take in triangle AOB and triangle COD, right? Angle 4 is equal to angle 5, proved. I've just proved it. Okay, angle 4 is equal to angle 5 and this angle CD is equal to, CD is equal to BA, it is given, opposite sides of square are equal, right? Angle 1 is equal to angle 8, it is also proved, right? So we can say that it implies that, we can say that triangle AOB is congruent to triangle COD by which rule? Angle side angle. So by this we can say that, let me write it here, we can say that this OB is equal to OD, OB is equal to OD and OA is equal to OC, OA is equal to OC by CPCT. Now we have proved two things. First, in the previous thing, in the previous triangles, we have proved diagonals are equal. With this, we have proved that diagonals bisect each other. We have proved that OB is equal to OD and OA is equal to OC. Now we just have to prove that this angles bisect each other at 90 degree. So how can we prove that? Let's see. I'm rubbing this. Okay. Now we have to take this in triangle AOB and triangle COB, right? In this triangle, AOB and triangle COB, right? OA is equal to OC, we have just proved by which property? We have OA is equal to OC, proved, we have just proved it in the previous one. OB is equal to OB, it is common, right? And AB is equal to CB, AB is equal to CB by which property? All sides of square are equal, it is also given. So it implies that triangle AOB is congruent to triangle COB by which rule? Side, all sides, right? And it implies that this angle AOB and this BOC, angle AOB is equal to angle COB by which CP, right? Now we have proved that AOB is equal to COB. Now similarly, if we take these two triangles, similarly triangle AOD is congruent to triangle COD by SSS, it implies angle AOD is equal to angle COD by CPCT. This triangle and this triangle is also equal. Now angle AOB plus angle COB is equal to 180 degree. This angle plus this angle is equal to 180 degree by which property? If you remember, linear angles, they are, this is a straight line and this is a line passing, linear angles, this is a straight line. So we have proved that AOB is equal to COB, so we can write twice of AOB is equal to 180 degree is equal to, it implies angle AOB is equal to angle COB is equal to 90 degree. Now this and this 90 we have proved. Similarly, this and this also by this AOD and COD, AOD plus COD is also equal to 180 degree, linear angles. So they will also be equal, so they will also be equal to 90 degree. Also angle AOD is equal to angle COD is equal to 90 degree. We can write similarly. Now we have proved that diagonals are equal, diagonals bisect each other, and diagonals bisect each other at 90 degrees, so hence proved. That is what the question was asking us, hence proved. It's a bit lengthy question. I told you in advance that to write steps by step, because I have already, I will just repeat the question. How did I solve it? The question was asking that we have to prove that diagonals of a square are equal and bisect each other at 90 degree. So first of all, I proved the diagonals are equal. I took this angle ADC and angle BCD. In this AD is equal to BC, this is common, and this angle and this angle is 90 degree. So by side angle, side, I have proved these two angles are congruent. So by CPCT, these diagonals are equal. The first part is proved. Second part, for second part, I took that AB and DC is a parallel line and this is a transversal, so angle 1 is equal to angle 8, similarly angle 2 equal to 7, 5 equal to 4 and 3 equal to 6, right? They are alternate angles, I have proved this. Now, I took this two opposite angles, AOB and COD. In this, angle 5 is equal to angle 4, angle 1 is equal to angle 2, and this AB is equal to DC, so angle side angle. So, triangles are congruent, that means OB is equal to OD and OA is equal to OC. Second part is proven that diagonals are bisecting each other. The third part is diagonals bisect each other at 90 degree. So for that, I took this triangle and this triangle. In this both triangles, AB is equal to BC, this is equal to this and this is common. So by side, I had proved that AOB is equal to COB. They are linear angles, so both angles will be 90 degree. Similarly, these two angles will also be 90 degree. So with this, I have proven that diagonals of a square bisect each other at 90 degree as well as diagonals are equal to each other. So this was fourth question. In this video, only up till here, we will discuss the remaining questions in the next video. So thank you very much.